There's blood in the water. When people fear, that's when you are supposed to attack. Okay, there are non-believers, disbelief in the world. Okay, look, listen, you might be inexperienced. Check this out. All right, listen to this. I like this. Most of the people never invested in anything before, I think. They are afraid when they realize that this crypto market is so volatile. The people get in panic and buy and sell uncontrolled, and they lose money in the end. So he's talking about AMP right here. Wherever you come up here, it looks like it's not moving. And when it does move, it looks like it's going down. All right, remember Warren Buffett, he you know, I don't consider him a god or anything, but when he said that when people fear, where there's fear, that's when you're supposed to take action and attack. I can't give investment advice, but I would say right about now would be the smartest time that in third person, I would invest in AMP, okay? Because it's bubbling, okay? It's not about what's on the surface, man. Remember, with a volcano, like these scientists try to predict whatever, oh, it won't erupt for another 2,000 years or something. Man, unless you're on the inside or underground, is really no way that you can know when that volcano is about to erupt. And when I say inside or underground, that's why I tell you guys all the time to read the white paper. All right, because what happened in the white papers on the roadmaps and implementation and usage cases, that is what translates eventually over here on the daily charts that you guys just sit and stare at with gigantic eyeballs and bifocals and telescopes attached to them, okay? Listen, man, you can't predict what's gonna happen. Quit paying attention to channels where they just sit here and stare at this and all of that. My predictions have been accurate majority of the time. I don't know everything either, and a lot of things are not based on my prediction or any of our predictions, because it has to be played out behind the scenes. And if we're not on the board of these cryptocurrencies, there's no way possible that we can get it right every time. So what I mean by that is, if I give you the end of the year prediction of a dollar, that is based upon full implementation and your participation of these cryptocurrencies. So you're like, David, what does that mean, my participation? Well, look from the outside point of view. The world thinks cryptocurrency is because nobody's using it really. You might hear people talk about using Bitcoin or buying something with Bitcoin majority of the time, but you're not hearing anybody talk about buying something with any of these tokens. The last one you heard about was Elon talking about rumoring him allowing you to purchase Teslas and everything like that. Dogecoin, which is one of the stupidest projects in the freaking world. Okay, now, and I mean that and stand on that, okay? Because of its inception, and it just has no purpose. That's a true crap coin, if you by definition. But AMP, Flexa, and ACH, they have movements behind them. And I'm not just talking about groups or something like that or long-term holders. I'm talking about their plans of implementation. But guess what, guys? They can't do it alone. If you don't want something to be a crap, if you don't want something to just fall off the face of the map, then you have to start hodling and you have to start using. That's the formula of success. So they can have a roadmap and white paper all they want, but if you don't hold, you're telling the whole world that these cryptocurrencies aren't even worth sticking by. It's just like a girlfriend or a wife. You sitting here trying to convince your homeboy she was the love of your life, but you used to go on missions with them every day and cheat on her. They're not gonna believe that. They don't feel that. Because you don't mistreat something that's valuable. So just because you come over here and you look at this and it's down, you decide, you start picking your next one. This is why you can't stay in a freaking relationship, all right? You start picking your next one. As soon as you see something looking like it's shadowing what you wanted to do, you panic sell. And that's why you won't never stack anything. So like he said over here, because remember, I told you to start considering these cryptocurrencies, the ones that mean something. I'm not talking about crap coins, ones that don't have any purpose. I'm talking about the ones with great technology behind them and a great plan. If you hold and use, they will pump eventually. So like he said, it seemed like a lot of people never invested in anything before. That's why they're hopping in, because that's why they're hopping off the train at the wrong stop is because most of them, this is their first investment. Cryptocurrency is their first investment and they're scared as hell. And they're used to trading. A lot of people are coming from the stock market and Forex world and stuff and all of that. So it's just habitual that they just jump in, jump out, jump in, jump out. It reminds me of Double Dutch. Makes me sick. All right, my point is this. Look, I'm not investing into something I can't hodl. When I was brand new at this crypto gang, I was talking about stuff like space grime. I ain't know nothing about usage cases or white papers or roadmaps, and I thought it was exciting. But now I know. I don't care what this is talking about over here right now, because if it's a long-term investment where 3 to 5 years or even a little bit longer, it can turn into millions or billions, then that's what the hell. Love you guys. Do a Jet Li sidekick to the like button.